Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today we're going to talk about the shaper tool, this tool right over here. You can use this to draw really quick shapes, and it's really good if you have just a Wacom Touch or something where you're actually drawing with your finger on the tablet. So I'm going to give you a few examples of how this can be used. So if we want to draw a circle, we can just do this, and it will snap to a circle, a square, that's actually a rectangle. But if you wanted to draw a square, you could keep it pretty close and it'll see it as a square. You can do a triangle, and you can even do polygons like this. And these shapes are pretty much all you can do. But then once you click on them, you can do some other things. Click on your V tool, you'll see this little diamond on the edge. And if you don't have this outer frame, you can hit Shift Command B to get your bounding box, or on a PC that would be Shift Control B. And we can move it right along the edge of that line and get more or less sides to our object. And there should be one little circle in there. I don't know if you can see it right there, but you can round the corners that way. I don't really want them that round for this. I'm gonna get our sides down. You can see a little better how it does around the corners. With the shaper tool selected, you can actually get rid of shapes by scribbling, or if you just scribble on the inside, it'll get rid of the fill. And then you can get rid of the stroke by doing the same on the edge. Now, one thing that's really cool about the shaper tool is that you can combine overlapping areas by scribbling too. So I'm gonna select this and pull it over the top of this square. Then we'll select both the circle and then hold shift and select the square. And then we can scribble between those. Now, when we overlap these, we have to get rid of our fill because it'll just move them if we try to scribble in there. So I'm going to hit the question mark to clear out the fill. And then we can get back on our shaper tool if you're not already. And then you can squiggle between them and it'll combine them. But the interesting thing is these are actually still independent objects. So if you hit Command Y, you can see that the shapes are still not actually combined. Now we've got a shaper group, and we can double click to get into isolation mode. So you can see inside your layer one, you have the shaper group. And now we can move these pieces around. You can do a squiggle to punch out that part of the shape. So now we've got something similar to what we could achieve with the Pathfinder down here. And then we can still move these around independent of each other. So it's a great little tool to check out. It is definitely something that I probably should incorporate into my workflow a little more. Please let me know if you've been able to incorporate this in your workflow and how you use it in the comments section below. Thank you, everyone, and I'll see you next Thursday for another graphic design tips tutorial.